And so what we need to do is understand that he provided healing, he provided salvation, he provided deliverance for us. And it's ours for the taking, you know. A friend of mine used to say, believe and receive, or doubt and go out. Okay, so we are believers because we believe that all things are possible with Christ. Okay, isn't that wonderful? Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Good. Okay. All right. The first scripture we're going to start off with is in Romans 12, verses 1 to 2. And it says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And do not be conformed to this world. Take note of that. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. So you get an idea of what I'm going to speak to you today, huh? Okay. Alright, so what is the state of your mind today? Are you troubled? Are you worried about everything out there? Think about it, friends. Are you always busy thinking about this, about that? Or are you always worried about the pressures in life? You know, if we are so worried, it means that we haven't believed. Think about that, okay? Really get that into your heart today. He says, let your hearts not be troubled. Cast your cares upon the Lord because he cares for you. He has done everything needed for us to receive from him. Amen. And all we need to do is believe. So when the storms are raging, what are we going to do? We're going to pray in spirit and in truth, but we're going to leave it all up to God and let him take over whatever our situation may be. You know, so often I feel that God is looking at to how we handle things. You know, do we shout? Do we get agitated? Do we get so anxious about everything? You serve a mighty God.
Amen.
And he is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all. But that is according to the power that is at work within you. And that's Ephesians 3, verses 20. Praise the Lord. Bless you. Okay, so, you know, God not only desires our best, but he also gives us his best. Do you give your best time to the Lord? Okay, I know that we all works in progress at this, but it's so important, really, that we give our best time to him. And, you know, your thoughts must be focused on God and his word. Most importantly, let it become a dwelling place in your hearts. The battlefield is really in the mind. Think about that, friends. And the devil, that is what he uses. That is his tool to get into you and to change your perspective. Okay. So he knows that if he can just get into your mind, he's got you. Okay. So, as Christians, we need to be renewed by the word of God. We can't just come up for prayer, and so often people will come up, and we'll be the same people manifesting all the time. It's because their mind is not renewed by the word of God. Because as a man thinks within his heart, so is he. Okay, so it's so important that the word of God, it becomes really an integral part of our being. That whatever we do, we preach, we speaking the word of God out loud there, and we defeat the devil by the word of our testimony, and that word must be God's word. Hallelujah. So the first step really to moving ahead in Christ is to yield to the instruction of the Holy Spirit by cultivating really an atmosphere of faith. We walk by faith and not by sight. It's so important, friends, that we do that, because if we walk by sight, you know, you're going to read the newspapers of what's happening around, and so many problems in the world today. He said that we would have problems in the world, but he has overcome it, and he's overcome it by the word that is within you. Okay, the word of God that resides within you, okay, is how we overcome it. You know, it's so important that we don't go by what we feel. We go by what we believe. Okay, so important there, friends. You know, words create your world. They really do. Jesus, even God said, let there be light. And praise the Lord, there was light. You know, he spoke you into being. And then you came. But it only happened by faith. Everything is framed by faith. And your words express your faith. Okay. So you can tell how much faith a person has by how they speak. Are they negative? Are they positive? Well, you'll get to see how much faith they have. And faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Okay, so Romans 12 verses 2, we saw in that scripture, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Okay, so we all desire breakthrough. How many of you desire breakthrough today?
Amen.
Praise the Lord, you're at the right place. Hallelujah. And financial freedom, you know, what are you looking for? Health, for financial freedom. And but, you know, as I said before, sadly, many people don't seek God through his word. And they look for every other avenue. Some go to the witch doctors. Some go to the Sangobas. Some people want to look for their blessing in places that do not bring blessing. And this is where they fall short. Okay? God is a jealous God, friends.
Amen.
He is a jealous God. And it's so important that we stand on the word of God. Whatever the word of God says about our situation is what we go by. Even if it contradicts everything that is happening in the world today, you stand on the word of God, and it is amazing. It is absolutely amazing how he watches over his word to perform it. And so he's just waiting for us to declare his word so that we could see that freedom in our lives. So praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even so, he says we are to seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Okay, do you see that? Not only to seek first the kingdom of God, but and his righteousness. So that all these things can be added unto us. Praise the Lord. So we need to change our pattern of thinking, friends. What are you thinking today? Do you think, well, I'm just going to try this place, you know? I'm just going to try and come up for prayer. Just remember, as a man thinks within his heart, so is he. And it's so important that we speak what we believe as well. Okay, so what are you thinking today? Because it will be done unto you as to how you have believed. Okay, so we need to change that pattern of thinking in our hearts, because Jesus is our healer. Okay, it's not about you and it's not about me. Amen. Okay, so your healing comes directly from our Lord Jesus Christ. Of course, we couldn't do that, but we can do it in the name of Jesus by the power of the Holy Spirit. And so we're going to change our thoughts and our minds today. Now, 2 Corinthians 10, verses 4 to 6. Let me say it again. 2 Corinthians 10, verses 4 to 6. And this could change you really if you take it to heart. The weapons we fight are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God, and we take every thought captive, every thought to make it obedient to Christ. Do you see what he's trying to tell us to do? To capture our thoughts, so that our thoughts are his thoughts and our words are his words. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And then it says, and we will be ready to punish every act of disobedience once your obedience is complete. Okay, so remember he said he sent his word and he healed them. Think about that. It is his word that heals. God's word heals. And of course, he's watching over his word to perform it. And he says that he will never change. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. We need to put our receivers on. You know, the problem is never with the transmitter, but always with the receiver. Okay. All right, and that's not as condemnation, because there's no condemnation to us who are in Christ. But we need to learn to be open to receive from him. Because sometimes we say, Lord, thus far and no further shall you go. We want him to go further in our lives, but we put up a veil. We put up a block in our own lives. And this is what stops us, because in Hebrews 11 verse 6 it says, without faith it is impossible to please him. If you want to please God, friends, it's not your tattoos, it's not your crosses that you wear. Only faith pleases our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Okay, he's looking to your heart, not to what you wear or how you are trying to please him in the natural. God is spirit, and we who worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So, you know, the unrenewed mind is always waging war against unbelief. The devil wants you not to believe. He knows what is available to you, so he's going to try and block you from even coming here today. You know, how many of you have really experienced a difficult time coming here today?
I can actually testify to that, because just
there
last
you
night
go.
My friend who was supposed to take me over the company car went wrong.
There you go.
My phone was taken as well. Mm-hmm. The process.
So there you go. So you can see what is happening out there. Okay, so when you come to a place where you're going to be changed, where you're going to be healed and delivered, you know, you may experience some obstacles along the way, especially if you're here for the first time today. All right, so, you know, many today confess faith in the word, but they deny it in action. That's why God calls us to be doers of the word, and not only hearers of the word, but doers. Okay, so as a Christian, what is our major problem today? you know, well, it's that battle that we actually fight in our minds. We really do need to renew our thoughts and our minds. And the thing that really keeps us from giving up is not what we see or what we feel or what we hear, but what we believe.
Amen.
Think about that. Okay, so what do you believe today? Remember Jesus said, everything is possible for them that
believe.
Amen. So God is looking to your hearts today, friends. The anointing is going to flow and everybody's going to be touched and blessed. But it's up to you as to how much of it you want to receive. Okay. Be an open vessel. Develop a free spirit in your hearts, friends. So important. You know what a free spirit is? It's one that just has no offenses against anyone. A free spirit is one that is just believes. Childlike faith. We spoke about that at the healing school. There were some of you here from the healing school. And that is it. Childlike faith. A child just believes until they grow up. Okay. So we must be led completely by the Word of God in order to see that change. Because God's Word will change us. It will. I've seen that happen in my ministry over the years, friends. How the anointing has grown. It's gone from glory to glory. Because I believe. I've seen it in the spirit before it has happened in the natural. We used to have a little handful of people that used to come at a time, 5 or 6, 8 years ago, you know. And the Lord is growing, and now He's bringing people from the United States and from all around South Africa as well. It's because I had this vision, I had this dream, and I believe in my heart, even before I see it. Because if you look at things in the natural, I tell you, friends, you'll have a lot of unbelief. Okay? You've got to see that job by faith. You've got to see that prosperity by faith. Beloved, He wishes above all that you be in health and prosper. That is His perfect will for you. Open up your heart to receive. Have a hearing heart. Okay. A hearing heart. We hear God with our hearts. Okay. We don't hear Him with our ears. You know, some people say, hey, man, I'm just listening to the Lord. Okay, that's not how we hear from God. We hear from God through our hearts. Okay, so what is your heart saying? You know, is your heart open to hear from the Lord? Okay, don't let there be a hindrance in any way from hearing Him. And one of the most important things that we would ever do is to receive Jesus as our Lord and our Savior. Okay. All right, so there's some of you here today, and I see it in my heart. You see, we need to give our lives to the Lord, okay? We can't just say, I've just come here to receive my healing. Reject the Savior. We can't do that. Your salvation is more important than your healing. Amen. Amen. All right, so we are going to be completely led by the Word of God. In the name of Jesus today. So, I want to end off with Philippians 4 verses 8, and I want you to keep that for your times of meditation. Okay. Finally, brothers. Okay. Do you want peace in your life? Do you want peace in your life? Okay. All right. You know, I went to the hospital and to pray for an elderly lady this week. And all she wanted was peace. That's it. I didn't even pray for her healing. I prayed for peace. Because that's what she asked for. And if you delight in the Lord, He'll give you the desires of your heart. You know, what do you want? You know, peace of heart is the best thing we can ever ask for, really. You know, because through that peace will come your healing. You know, your body, you know, how many of you know when you're stressed, you know, your body starts to tingle a bit and you just feel a little bit, you know, anxious and not only that, but then it affects your sinuses, and for some it affects their stomach. And, you know, there's so many other ways that stress affects one, but just to have that peace of heart, it's so precious, really. And, you know, as a Christian, when people are coming against you, to just show them love, because as a Christian, we are known by the love that we have for one another. And to respond back in love, wow, it's so amazing. Friends, let's get peace in our hearts today. And that scripture in Philippians 4, verses 8 says, finally, brothers, okay, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. And what does the rest of that scripture say? Who's got it open? And the God of peace will be with you. But that is provided that you change your thoughts to think on things that are lovely and of good report. Okay. How can we expect to receive from the Lord with unforgiveness and bitterness in our hearts towards somebody? Okay. He can only confirm His word over our lives, friends. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Well, hallelujah. So we still have no electricity, but how many of you can sing? Praise the Lord. You sing?